Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's take a look at AirDrop for iOS 7. So AirDrop is one of those powerful new features of iOS 7. What it allows you to do is transfer data, say a photo, from one iOS device to another iOS device directly. That means you don't need to be on the same Wi-Fi network. There doesn't even need to be a Wi-Fi network available. And you don't even need to be doing it over mobile. You're actually transferring data directly from one device to the other. It makes sharing photos with a friend very easy. So here I have my iPhone and my iPad. And they're in the same room together, so AirDrop should work. So first thing I want to do is make sure I have AirDrop turned on properly for both devices. You can do that by bringing up Control Center, swiping up from the bottom, and you can see there's AirDrop, and I can set it to off, contacts only, or everyone. So I'm just going to keep it at everyone there, and I'm going to do the same thing here for the iPad, and there is it set for everyone. So now I'm going to go into the Photos app on my iPhone, and I can go into a picture and then use the share button, or I can hit the select button there. I can select one or more photos like that one and use the share button. Either way, bring up the share button and then you see AirDrop at the top, and it's going to look for and find nearby devices that have AirDrop enabled. So there we go. There's my iPad. Now when I tap it, it will attempt to send it to the iPad there. And you can see on the iPad I get a preview there of the photo, and I can hit accept or decline. So you end up with the photo in your camera roll just like if you took the picture yourself. So this is a great way to share photos. You're in the same room with other people. Somebody takes a picture and you say send that to me. They could send it to you right there and then. You don't have to be on the same Wi-Fi network. You don't have to know each other's email addresses or phone numbers or anything. AirDrop simply finds the device that's nearby and allows that person to send that photo. So theoretically you can share just about anything. Now the app's got to be updated for iOS 7 so that it can use the new share functionality. You can share notes, you can share contacts, in Safari you can share links to the web page you're visiting. You can also use it in third-party apps. Like I noticed in Evernote, I can share a note from there to somebody else as well. So AirDrop requires the latest Wi-Fi chips inside of your iOS device to work because it has to do this communication between devices, which means it needs the latest hardware. So basically it's iPhone 5 or newer. The iPad 4th generation, that's the one that came out in the later part of 2012 or newer, and the iPod Touch 5th generation. Basically, if you have the Lightning connector at the bottom of your device, then you should have AirDrop. If you have the older dock connector at the bottom of the device, then you have the older Wi-Fi chipset and you won't be able to use AirDrop on that device. Now you can't use AirDrop to share something from iOS to Mac or vice versa. Both Mac and iOS have something called AirDrop and they work in similar ways. But you can't share across. One of the problems there is that Macs have an open filing system. You can create files of any type and put them anywhere you want. And you can just view folders filled with different files. In iOS, there's documents, not really files, and these documents are stored specific to the app. Photos in the Photos app, Pages documents in the Pages app, etc. You don't have this open file system where you can just look at a bunch of different types of files. So going back and forth from one to the other would need to solve that problem before it could be enabled. In the meantime, there are other ways to share things, of course, all the same old ways that have worked before, sharing between iOS and Mac, including using iCloud, say, to share photos via PhotoStream, things like that. So I hope you like this look at AirDrop for iOS. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it will just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched and go to that page. Underneath the video you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.